Good afternoon, everyone.
I, Nikunj Mukim, on behalf of Group 5, welcome you to our PowerPoint presentation on action and reaction. Due to the pandemic, we all are not able to attend our schools. Due to this, our teachers have arranged art integrated project. And without any delay, I would like to present my presentation. I hope you like it. Thank you.
All once more, a very good afternoon. So as to get acquainted with our topic, I would like to quote, "Life is a boomerang. What you give, you get." The topic that has been allotted to us in action and reaction acts on different direction. Here, we are also going to show from where we get this law, an example of action and reaction forces. Moreover, we are also going to show a small activity to understand action and reaction forces in a better way. Thank you.
As far we know, Newton has given us three laws on motion, mentioned in his book Philosophia Naturalis Principia Mathematica, published in the year 1687. So, today we are only going to discuss about the third law of motion. So, the third law of motion states that to every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. So, it means that the force always act in the pairs in opposite direction. This means if an action force acts on the right side, then the reaction force will always be in left side. Thank you.
So, let me say you a funny example to understand the third law of motion. I guess you all have seen weighing scales in vegetable shops. Now let's give two people two weighing scales and ask them to start pushing it over each other. And always you will notice one of them is trying to push it harder than the other. When two people try to push it, we will see different measures in the weighing scale. Now think if the two weighing scale is attached with a spring in the center and say both of them to pull it again, one will try to pull it harder than the other. But now the measures of both weighing scales will be equal. Hence, we realize that no matter how harder one pushes to the other, the force will be constant. This is due to third law of motion.
Newton's third law is evident in many parts of a table tennis match. Two most obvious examples are when the ball hits a paddle and when the ball hits the table. In both the instances, both objects are making contact. According to Newton's third law, when the ball hits anything, say object X will exert an equal and opposite force on the ball. So in the above example, whether the ball makes contact with a paddle or with the table actually exerts the force onto the ball equal to that of the force the ball has exerted onto the table or paddle.
To understand the third law of motion in a better way, let's perform a small activity. So, we need few things that are easily available in our home. Those are one paper, four bottle caps, four wheels, straws, scissors, glue and a tape. To make our model, first we need to cut a paper of size that is convenient for you. Here we have taken 12 cm and 5 cm. Then we will attach two straws on both the corner for the axles. Now make a hole in each bottle cap and put it into the straws. Add some glue so that the wheels don't escape from the straws. Now cut 3 to 4 small pieces of straws and put it inside the balloon and wrap it with a cello tape so that the balloon doesn't escape. Finally, now attach the balloon to the car. Hence, our model is ready. Now we can perform our activity. We now will blow up the balloon and leave the car in a table. We will now observe that the car starts moving just opposite to the air being released. This is due to the third law of motion that if action, that is the air, is moving towards the left direction, then the reaction, that is the car, will move towards the right. Thank you.
I guess you all enjoyed it. So the members who put their efforts after this presentation under the guidance of Samudra Chaudhary are Dev Das Gupta, the group leader, Sushant Sarkar, Suryava Chaudhary, Nikunj Mukim, Palak Chidaniya, Srishti Singh, Rehan Ali, Angad Shah and Abhishek Ghosh. Thank you for tracing time out and being here today.
So with this we want to conclude our PowerPoint presentation.
We hope that this presentation has helped you all. Thank you.